Yes, boys, as I told you, just a quick recap of the lesson before I explain and go ahead. Lesson number four, air pressure. We saw that near the surface of the earth, around, it is a covering of the air, layer of air, sphere, atmosphere, okay? And these are the different layers of air. The top layer is exerting a pressure on the layer which is closest to the surface of the earth. So air in the atmosphere exerts pressure on the surface of the earth that we saw. Then we also saw the phenomena which will occur because of this air pressure. Because of the air pressure, we saw the two phenomena which will occur in the nature, in the atmosphere, that is storm and precipitation. You know, I explained you about storm. I explained you what is precipitation. Then, I'm moving ahead. As I told you, air pressure on the surface of the earth. Here, on the surface of the earth, air pressure is not uniform. In all the places, air pressure is not uniform. Somewhere it will be more, somewhere it will be less. So, air pressure is not uniform, not equal on the surface of the earth. Then we also saw that air pressure keeps on changing from time to time, according to the time, whether it's day or night or after a few hours gap, there will be a change in air pressure. And then later, moving ahead, we saw the factors affecting the air pressure. I hope you remember the first factor affecting the air pressure was the altitude, the height. As you move away, air becomes thinner. Okay, so first factor affecting the air pressure is your altitude. Second factor is the temperature of the region. First altitude, second factor is the temperature of the region. Then the third factor affecting is water vapor. The water content in the air means your water vapor. So amount of water vapor in the air is the third factor affecting the air pressure. Then we saw near the surface of the earth. Near the surface of the earth, you have the dust particles, water vapor, and heavy gases. This amount of these three are very high near the surface of the earth. And as you go away from it, it will decrease. The amount will decrease. Then we saw, as you move higher and higher, air will become thinner and thinner. As you will move higher and higher, air becomes thinner and thinner. So this is how you can see the air will become thinner. Thinner means air will become rare. Moving ahead, I explained you about the experiment, the flying lantern, where you lit the candle inside, and because of this heat of the candle, what will happen to the air inside the lantern? The air gets heated up. Okay, after the air heats up, it expands, and then it becomes lighter. And when it becomes lighter, it will move up. If air is moving up, that means the lantern is also lifted towards the sky. This we saw. Then we also saw how the temperature and air pressure are related to each other. When the temperature is high in that region, air pressure will be low. Opposite. When the temperature is low, air pressure will be high. So in this way, there is a relation between temperature and air pressure. Then I explained you that near the equator, the temperature is very high. That means rays of the sun are perpendicular over here. So if the temperature is high, what will happen to the air here? The air gets heated up near the equator. Then it will move towards the upper direction. Why? Because air has become lighter in weight. This we saw. So temperature rises, air gets heated up, it becomes lighter and it rises upwards. The air pressure, what will happen to the air pressure there, man? Here, when the temperature is high, slowly, slowly, the air pressure will become less. Air pressure is low. Rise in temperature, decrease in air pressure. Then I explained you how the rays of the sun are falling on the earth. See, this is your earth, north pole, south pole, and the center line which divides the earth into equal parts, imaginary line, equator. Now, near the equator, the rays of the sun are perpendicular. Okay, and near the poles, the rays of the sun are slanting. That means the heat received over here of the sun is more. The heat is more. Here the heat received is less. What happens because of this? Temperature zones are created on the earth because of the heat received from the sun. So, we saw the temperature zones also which were created because of the heat. As you know, I explained you this 23 degree 30 minutes is your Tropic of Cancer. This 23 degree 30 minutes is your Tropic of Capricorn. Okay. This is 0 degree equator. So, the rays of the sun are perpendicular in this area. Rays of the sun are perpendicular in this area means temperature is very, very high. So, which zone is formed over here? The torrid zone. Total three zones are there on the surface of the earth because of the heat of the sun. Torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Okay. Now, let us see the extension. Torrid zone extends from 0 degree to 23 degree north and south. 23 degree 30 minutes north and south. Or you can also say 23 degree half and a half north, 23 degree half south. Okay. This is the extension of the torrid zone. Extension of the temperate zone, 23 degree north to 66 degree north and south. Same degrees in the south. Extension of the frigid zone in both the hemispheres is from 66 degree 30 minutes north to 90 degree north pole. 66 degree 30 minutes south to 90 degree south pole. Your frigid zone. Okay. So, you got the three zones. You know the extension. You know this line Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, and the rays of the sun are perpendicular over here. Here, less perpendicular. Here, very much slanting near the poles. And this is how the three zones are created. Now, let's go ahead and check our pressure belts. Heat received from the sun, as I told you, is uneven, perpendicular towards the equator, slanting towards the poles. Now, here, again I am explaining you, equator at 0 degree, another imaginary line in the northern hemisphere, Tropic of Cancer. Next imaginary line in the southern hemisphere, Tropic of Capricorn. Rays of the sun are perpendicular where? From Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn. Okay. So, this is which zone? Torrid zone. Here the rays are perpendicular. That means the temperature is? Temperature here will be high. And if the temperature here is high, which pressure belt will be created? High temperature, low pressure belt. Here it will be a low pressure belt which will be created near the equator. Okay, let's go ahead and see the different pressure belts on the earth. Pressure belts we have to see, and even we have to see the planetary winds. So, see the first pressure belt. Here, equatorial low pressure belt. Where this belt is formed? Near the equator. Why near the equator? Rays of the sun are perpendicular. Temperature is high. If the temperature is high, air gets heated up, air becomes lighter in weight, it expands, and from here the air will move up. Okay, after air is heated up, it becomes lighter in weight and it moves up. So when the air moves up, what will happen to the pressure over here? It will become low. So when the temperature is high near the equator, low pressure belt is formed. Which low pressure belt is formed? Equatorial low pressure belt. What is the extension? 5 degree north to 5 degree south. Okay, let's go ahead. Now you have to guess. As I told you, air will move up. It comes over here. The air cools down here in this belt. So what will happen when the air cools down? Temperature will be low. Which pressure belt will be formed? Low temperature. Pressure will be high. So there will be a high pressure belt. Okay. Look here. Mid-latitudinal high pressure belt is formed. Mid-latitudinal means these latitudes are in the middle. So it is known as mid-latitudinal. And I explained to you why high pressure belt is formed. Because the temperature is low. Low temperature, high pressure. Okay, so you got now in both the hemispheres, mid-latitudinal high pressure belt is formed. Why? Because the air from here, it moved up. It settled over there. It cooled down. Temperature became low and pressure became high. So this is how your equatorial low pressure belt is created near the equator. And high pressure belt is created near the mid latitudes in the both the hemisphere. Extension is what? Mid latitudinal high pressure belt. Extension is 25 degree to 35 degree north, 25 degree to 35 degree south. Okay. Now, high pressure belt. See here, low pressure, high pressure. Now look at this picture here. As you are moving up, the curvature of the earth is becoming less. This area is very less. So, area between the latitudes also will be less. So, you must have guessed it now, which pressure belt will be formed? Low pressure belt will be formed over there. Due to the earth's curvature, the area between the two parallels is very less. So friction is also less. Air is thrown out and a low pressure belt is formed. Okay, the subpolar low pressure belt is formed from 55 degree to 65 degree north and from 55 degree to 65 degree south. Subpolar low pressure belt. And as you go ahead near the poles, temperature is very less. So when the temperature is low, polar high pressure belt is formed. Low temperature, high pressure. So this is how we studied about equatorial low pressure belt, mid-latitudinal high pressure belt, subpolar low pressure belt, and the polar high pressure belts. They are alternate. Low, high, low, high. Okay. This is how the pressure belts are formed. Now, let us see about the planetary winds. Which are the winds? See, near the equator, the winds which are blowing near the equator are the easterlies. In the northern hemisphere also and in the southern hemisphere also. Easterlies are the winds which are blowing. Okay. See the direction of the winds. This way. That means what? Winds always blow from high pressure towards the low pressure. Always remember, whenever you are drawing a diagram of this pressure belt, do not do mistake while drawing the arrows. Arrows means anyhow you don't have to draw the arrows. Here there is a meaning for it. Winds. This is related to winds. So winds will always blow from high pressure belt towards a low pressure belt. Okay. See here also. Now this is a high pressure belt. This is a low pressure belt. So from high to low, look at this southern hemisphere. See again here, the wind's direction is from high to low. It is always from high to low. Remember this. So which are the winds blowing near the equator? Easterlies. So which are the winds over here? Winds between mid-latitudinal to subpolar? Westerlies. So which are the planetary winds blowing here? Westerlies. Okay. And which are the winds towards the poles? Polar winds. Okay. So polar region, 0 degree. The temperature is 0 degree, below 0 degree. So high pressure belt is formed. So you understood the entire pressure belts and planetary winds. You should always remember, as you studied about temperature zones, you also studied about pressure belts today. So temperature zones are continuous. Pressure belts are not continuous. Okay. Temperature zones, they spread. From where they spread? From equator to the poles. That is from torrid zone to frigid zone. What about pressure belts? How they spread? From areas of high and low pressure are found in different regions from equator to the poles. What happens because of the air pressure? Effects of air pressure? What happens? Generation of winds, origin of winds, okay? Then even origin of storm takes place. Generation of storms. This is the effect of air pressure. And the third effect is the convectional type of rain. Now, what do you mean by convectional type of rain? See here, this is a mountainous area, so mountain. This is your mountain. Now, it is raining on one side, but it is not raining on the other side, the opposite side. Why? Mountain is an obstacle. So this side it is not raining, but the left side it will rain. The regions will get rain and the right side regions will not get rain. This type of rain is called convectional type of rainfall. Fourth factor, effects of air pressure, which is the fourth factor? It affects the breathing activity. As I told you that mountaineers, they carry the oxygen cylinders with them when they climb the mountain. Why? Air is rare over there. Air pressure is low over there. This will affect the breathing activity, your inhalation and exhalation process. Now look at this picture. In this picture, you can see the blue lines. You see here, these are the blue lines. This is one line of 1013 millibars. Second line is of 1016 millibars. See, the digits vary. That means what? On the same line, the pressure is the same. But these two lines, the pressure is different. One is 1013, one is 1016. So what? There are different lines which are there on the earth, which shows you the air pressure. What are these lines on a map called? Lines on a map joining the places of equal pressure. On the map, what are they called? Isobars. Okay, remember this. Lines joining the places of equal pressure are called isobars. What is the unit of air pressure? Millibars. Lines joining the air pressure equal on the map, they are isobars. But which is the unit? What is the unit? See, for temperature you have, what is the unit of temperature? Degree Celsius. We measure the temperature in degree Celsius. Similarly, we measure the air pressure in millibars. So what is the unit of air pressure? Millibars. And this instrument, you must have guessed it. This instrument is used to measure air pressure. The name of the instrument is barometer. Barometer, 770 millibars, 780 millibars. In this way, a barometer is used to measure air pressure and the unit is the millibars. Okay.